Hey there, it's Dr. Justin Marchegiani, and today's talk is going to be on how does one get a gut infection? I get this question all the time because I work with about 40 different patients a week from all over the world, and typically during the week I'm reviewing at least 20 or so parasite tests or gut function tests, whether it's a SIBO test or whether it's a stool test that's looking for either infectious material or an imbalance in gut flora and gut bacteria. So we're gonna break down how that happens. How does one fall prey? Why does conventional medicine really just stink at detecting it? And then also what the steps are moving forward from a stress perspective. Again, I want you people to just be able to wrap their heads around how does someone get sick with a gut infection when today we're just so focused on that only being a third world country issue, yet so many people have it. So let's roll up our sleeves and dive in. All right, so infection exposure versus compromised immunity. What I mean by that is, if you get exposed to a large amount of an infectious material, let's say you drink some really polluted water, like, you know, you're out hiking or whatever, and there's a beaver's dam over there, and you bend down and get some water to your face, and then that day you have a lot of diarrhea, that may just be a large bolus of the infectious material. So imagine here is our beaver water here, and there's just so much infectious material. So for this type of parasite infection, this is a giardia infection. Beaver fever, if you will, where you get exposed to some of the particulate, the giardia compound in the beaver stool, which is in the water. You drink that water, and there's such a large amount of that beaver giardia parasite in there that it overwhelms your body. The infection exposure is so high that it overwhelms your immune system. Whether you're swimming in bad water, whether you're eating bad food, you're going to a country where there's a typical maybe practices of cleaning the hands aren't quite as common, or they don't have the extra cleanliness in the water, the sanitation and the filtration in the water supply, that may cause you to get an infection just because the overall exposure of the parasite, the amount of spores or cysts are so high, it overpowers your immune system even if you're healthy. That's number one. Scenario two is that we have a compromised immune system. All right, so compromised immune system means there's chronic stress on our immune system. And let's dig into that a little more. So what causes chronic stress? Well, we have something known as allostatic load. Allostatic load is nothing more, visualize it like a stress bucket here. And we put stress balls in this bucket. And a big ball that I see going in that bucket is gluten. That's a really big ball that goes in that bucket. Pesticide exposure. Again, blood sugar issues. We could even say sleep. We could even say GMOs. We could even go deeper, low stomach acid. I like HCL, low stomach acid. Right? So these are all different stressors that go in that stress bucket. And then out the bottom, what happens over here is our immune system, our immune function drops. So we have a decrease in immune function. As our allostatic load increases, it increases our ability, I should say, it decreases our ability to fight off foreign invaders. And one of the big things that happens, we'll talk about it in a little bit when we talk about nervous system function, it decreases our stomach acid. And our stomach acid is our way that we kind of come in there and clean things up. It's like the bleach on the dirty kitchen table. It's like the force field that the Star Trek uses to protect themselves from the Klingons. It's that natural protective barrier that kind of sterilizes things coming into the body to make sure things are clean, right? It's like your mom telling you when you're little to wash your fruit and vegetables before you eat it. It's kind of like that. That's what stomach acid does. It has a disinfecting role, and it also has a role in which it activates proteolytic enzymes, right? Big word, proteolytic, protein breaking down. So enzymes that help break down protein, enzymes that also help break down protein can also help break down parasitic infection. So if you have low enzyme levels, low stomach acid levels, you probably also have low IgA levels, which are that protective mucosal antibody barrier that lines that intestinal tract, that lines the stomach, and that will make you open to a lot of these infections. So kind of back up here, infection exposure, you get a whole bunch of it, you may be sitting pretty, you may be a monk that's just totally zen-like all day, but you get a large amount of infectious bolus, infection amount of cysts or spores from that infection, so large it could compromise anyone's immune system. That's scenario one. Scenario two is we have a compromised immune system from an increase in allostatic load. Where's that stress coming from? Gluten, pesticides, poor sleep, low stomach acid, poor diet, skipping meals. Maybe we're eating food allergens outside of a healthy paleo diet. Maybe we're eating eggs and nuts and seeds that we have an allergy to. Maybe we have Hashimoto's and we have low thyroid function, which can affect our immune system. Maybe we have a gut infection outside of a parasite, like a SIBO or dysbiosis or a fungal overgrowth. So there's a lot of things that can compromise our immune system. So we're gonna dig in a little bit deeper now to the nervous system here. So most people are overactivating their sympathetic nervous system. And that's your SNS, sympathetic nervous system. So the scale here is heavier, right? So the bigger person typically tips the scale down, right? So if we have more sympathetic nervous system activity, that decreases, right? So I'm gonna write here, increase SNS. What that does is it decreases our immune function. Okay, decreased immune function. One of the things that also happens here is our digestive ability, so decreased digestion also happens. Anytime we have decreased digestion, our ability to fight off any invader coming into our body is now thwarted or decreased. So increased sympathetic nervous system, that decreases our immune function. While we have an increased SNS, our immune system is now decreased, and our ability to defend the outer world from the inner world is now impeded because our digestion is now lower. So now let's flip the switch. So let's say we're gonna increase our parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, let's increase parasympathetic nervous system. And let's decrease sympathetic nervous system. And let's see how that equation looks. So first things first, when we're increasing parasympathetics, that's our rest and digest, that's our repair. Now, why is that important? Because when our sympathetics are firing, it's because we're in a fight or flight state. This part of our nervous system evolved from fleeing or fighting an enemy or fleeing an animal. Now we have little micro fight and flight states, right? Dealing with traffic is our little micro fight and flight state. Dealing with our boss is a micro fight and flight state. So all of these things can be a major stressor on the body, but they just add up. They're really small, but they add up. So the sympathetic nervous system, it's funneling energy to deal with the stress constantly. So our immune system takes a lot of energy. So if we're so focused on the stress out here, our body will shunt energy from healing and recovering and digesting because its goal is survival. So we want to take our body out of that survival state by calming down the sympathetic nervous system. And that allows to shunt more of our energy, more of our nerve energy, more of our blood flow internally. And what that does is that supports our nervous system functioning better. So when we have an increased PNS, that's parasympathetic nervous system, that increases our immune function. Okay? And our peripheral or our parasympathetic nervous system also is our rest and digest. So it helps us rest, it helps us repair, and that actually helps improve digestion. That improves digestion. So, you know that old wise tale that maybe your mom told you when you were a kid that said, well, how did it go again? If you should wait at least 2 hours after you eat before you jump in the pool, or you may sink, right? That old wise tale. Why is that? Well, because our parents or our grandparents, however that tale was passed along, intuitively knew that getting in the water and treading water or swimming or being active could activate our sympathetic nervous system, moving blood flow away and creating this massive amount of indigestion in our stomach. So that's kind of where that came from. I think it really underlines how important activating our peripheral or our parasympathetic nervous system is for overall health. So you can see with increased parasympathetic nervous system response, decrease SNS, sympathetic nervous system response, that helps our immune system and that improves digestion. So one of the first places we look at when we have a compromised immune system is our gut. And part of that is, well, just because we have 70 to 80% of our immune cells there. And our GALT and our MALT, our gastric associated lymphoid tissue, lymph, that's part of our white blood cells. And then our MALT, our mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. So anytime we're dealing with any type of chronic illness, especially parasite infections, we always look to the overall nervous system status. We look to the allostatic load, and then we want to see, is it just a massive overwhelm of infectious material, number one, or is it a compromised immunity? And I see a lot of it happening with compromised immunity. And because so many people get a gut infection, they have maybe this diarrhea or digesting bloating episode and then it's gone, but then they're left with brain fog or mood issues, and then it lasts for 5 or 10 years. They go get tested by multiple doctors, spend tens of thousands of dollars, then they come see me and they say, well, I've got this brain fog or this mood issue or this inability to perform or focus. And I say, let's look deeper at the gut. And then they're like, but that doesn't make sense. I don't have these typical gut symptoms. We dig in deeper and it's like a parasite, H. pylori, blasto, giardia. And then once we start treating this, it's like they come out of the fog and things start to lift. And it's amazing how many parasitic symptoms may not even be intestinally related. May not be your bloating, your gas, your diarrhea, your flatulence, your reflux, may not even be that. But a lot of times, because the digestive system is at the foundation of our body's optimal function, so many things can be affected, right? Inflammation in the gut, inflammation in the brain, mood issues, brain fog, memory issues. If we don't digest proteins, well, that's where all of our hormones and neurotransmitters come from. Hormones and neurotransmitters affect everything. So you can see how if you have a gut issue, that this totally spins out of control. And again, most of the tests out there aren't comprehensive enough or aren't specialized enough to pick up a lot of these infections. I see a lot of people that have done your conventional based testing versus a more specialty lab, and we tend to find it and pick it up more frequently. Sometimes we gotta run two tests at once, but it can make a big difference. So if you're trying to figure out where you fit into this category here and you think you may have a gut issue that's underlying maybe some of your brain fog or your mood issues, or maybe you just have straight gut issues like diarrhea, depression, or diarrhea, bloating, gas, reflux, constipation, etc. Well, click on screen or click below. Feel free to reach out to me so we can dig in a little bit deeper, see if there's any other glandular dysfunction like adrenal or thyroid issues too. Sometimes that can be compounding a lot of the problems. So again, this is Dr. J signing off. Make sure you click on screen and subscribe so you can get access to more great videos just like this. Thanks. Have a great night.